put up a wood circulating heater, the first wood circulating heater I'd ever seen. I put it up in there. And that's how we heated the house. Anyway, it was a lawyer. Of course, I didn't know the guy. He come by, it snowed that night, or that day. Anyway, he come by the house there going to somebody's people lived down at the Y, they call it, the little community, just down the road from us. Anyway, he lost control of his car and got in a ditch. And there was ice on the ground, and you couldn't, you know, get no traction. I couldn't pull him out, so I brought him up to the house and cleared him to use a telephone. We didn't have no telephones there in the community. Even old man George Holmes didn't have one. And anyway, we went down to Cannon Line. Buck Lane's liquor store had a telephone. We used it. It was a phone outside, and we used it. And he called Fordyce, and they sent a record up there to get him. Anyway, we had a big pan of parched peanuts on a heater, and you could smell them. Well, we was used to, you know, stuff like that. That guy just went wild over there. He shelled, eat peanuts. But he sent us all the kids presents after that. He couldn't believe we had 8 little kids, you know, just doorstep high. Each one of them just sitting there on the couch. But that evening I come in from work.
You was working where?
At Pink Banner's Packing Company.
Okay.
Come in from work. And all them trucks sitting there in the yard. They had antennas on them and everything. It's Game Warden. 2 of them was federal Game Warden. The other one just a local Game Warden. Anyway, the local Game Warden was standing at the door, and he told me, you know, they had a warrant to search my house for deer hunting out of season, spotlighting deer at night and all that kind of stuff.
Were you doing that then?
No. Anyway, now unless we get hungry.
Yeah.
I told him I worked at Pink Banner's Packing Company. I got all my meat at a discount, and a lot of it give to me. Mm-hmm. And it was, my freezer was full of vegetables and meat from the packing house. But they had to check because, you know, it was their job. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I found out, he wouldn't tell me, but he showed me on the paper the guy that turned me in was Everett Smith's brother. Junior Smith ran there. Well, he called him. They called up 3 different times. Because I was down in there, I was out behind the house shooting my gun.
Yeah.
I was shooting a gun. Because this guy gave me a gun, or I gave him a haircut, and he gave me the gun for the haircut or something. And anyway, he wouldn't shoot. It was supposed to be an automatic, and I'd been working on it. I finally got it to where it would shoot like it was supposed to. Anyway, they thought I was hunting. That's what they claimed, that I was hunting. Anyway, I made the remark that that'd be the first place I'd go if I'd go, you know, going to search somebody's house. They tried to get me to sign a search warrant. I said, no, it ain't none of my business what he does. I don't do that. But after that happened, them guys felt so bad about it. They was they caught some people down on Sling River with nets. It wasn't licensed. And they brought a big old ice chest full of fish by there and left it with us. And then one night he woke me up. Somebody had hit a deer and killed it. And he brought it up there and wanted me to do something with it. Big old 10-point buck. I carried it over to her daddy's overnight, and they hung it up out there. I had to come back and go to bed because I had to go to work. But
so Papa Lovell drifted down?
Yeah.
And they lived at Home Special during that time?
No, they lived over at Keedron.
Keedron, so
yeah.
You drove over all that.
I had to drive over to Keedron.
Sable and spot in heaven close to you. If my wish is more than I deserve, forgive me. Up in heaven, any place would surely do. But I've done my best on earth, that's why I'm asking for a little spot in heaven close to you. At the altar